what we call it as progenetics. To design children as per the order of nature is known as progenetics. To design the children against the rule of nature by artificial influence or technology is known as eugenetics. And studying about the origination of both of these things is known as epigenetics. So, this should become a syllabus. India Century Mission, certainly I think that we are going to publish at least one syllabus. BA, BSc, or even we can make Visharada, Nipuna, or some other, we can give a different nomenclature. Complete syllabus. Top to bottom, we have to make everything. These are just some informative exercises where we are giving the preliminary divisions. With the preliminary divisions are so attractive and informative, how will be the real deeper exploration we are taking inside? So, we are going to take progenetics today. Now we can note down a few points. It is to design the quality or ability of any child. That is known as progenetics. I have already given the explanation. In this progenetics, there are three layers. The first layer is Rupa Nirnaya, Yoni Nirnaya, Ayu Nirnaya, Ojo Nirnaya. Rupa Nirnaya, Yoni Nirnaya, Ojo Nirnaya, Ayu Nirnaya, Guna Nirnaya, Medha Nirnaya and Vritti Nirnaya. I am not going to give the exhaustive mantras because I want to know how many of you are really interested. It is for three people. One, the first type of people, they are the would-be parents. Would-be parents, they may be of two types. One who is what we call priming and multi in medical language they used to say, who is going to get the first child, or even already they are having child, they would make a design child now. That is a destinal child who has been given by fate, and let it be a design child as per the swapeksha, kulapeksha and viswapeksha. You can get this opportunity. For them it is available. Number two, even they are grown up. Even though they are grown up already, those who are married, those who are not married, those who have got children are just now going to get children, it is immediately useful. And second thing, it will be useful for people, those who are going to direct their brother-in-law, then son-in-law, daughters and other family persons. Knowledge is very much useful. Even though they are not going to use, they can give it to somebody else. Third thing, promoters of this knowledge, one or two people can have a syllabus, master these mantras and take such workshop. I cannot attend all workshops at all places. They can guide other people, those who are known as public promulgators. They cannot get into this project. So, it is useful for all people. To brief it is useful for all. So, what is Rupa Nirnaya? You can design the Rupa of the child by a sankalpa, not by your ambition. It is not an ambitious that I want to have a child like Shah Rukh Khan or something. If you just keeping on thinking like that, that is different. That is perfectly ambitious. I am talking about a procedural system wherein by your behavioral mechanics that couples with a theodynamic system of existence and modulation. That is a theodynamic system. What is theodynamics? Utilizing the power of God and belief of God for a dynamic output is known as theodynamics. Somebody told, if you go to religion, you will become soft. If you go to religion, you will become soft. You won't be useful for anything. That's why I hate religion. I told that religion has both the dimensions. Wherever you are unnecessarily hard and going to harm others, it will make you to go soft. Wherever you are soft, by which you are trampled and victimized by others, it will make you to go hard. So theodynamics is an area where we are not going to close our eyes, we will open our eyes. Where we are going to not sit like this, but we are going to raise our hands and blow people and throw them into the darkish hell. So theodynamics is a very potential dimension of this thing, because lot of the people who generally just take shelter to the religious shrines for justification of their errors or for expiation of their sins and for improving their own family, those people are self-centric, or those people are guilty of their mistakes, those people are into justification of their own mistakes by means of saying that it is very common, it is very casual and God is all forgiving, etc. These type of imbecile, impotent tinsels of the religion, they are spoiling the religion's real progress, not allowing the people to go in the theodynamics type. So theodynamics should always participate with the top, your ambition. Mere ambition is useless. Mere theodynamics without ambition is also useless. So there must be a blended mixture of all of these things. So Rupa is a shape. It should be a divine shape. It can be because at the time I want to just conduct one more class for that. I have classified this 40 to 42 weeks of period of pregnancy and labor and delivery into 42 various divisions. 42 is the maximum. It is just a common classification. I am going to classify. Already there is a trimester classification in gynecology. There are three trimesters. Apart from these, I want to classify into 42 classifications. In each and every classification, what are the changes that are happening? What are the changes, mega changes and subtle changes happening? How mantras can influence and mold? Rupa Pradarshana means forming a shape. Each and everybody, they are having five formations. One is a resemblance formation. I have already told about this system. In the first lecture, I think that I have told that. While framing the shape of the child, the Shastra says that Tvashta Yonim Kalpayatu Vishtor Yonim Kalpayatu. That is a Vedic mantra. In which Tvashta is Vishwakarma. He is creating just, it is known as bio-architecture. Just as you are making landscaping, which is geo-architecture, temple architecture, shaping the child is known as bio-architecture. Number one, what is the special standard? It is human being. What is the gender? It is male or female. The third thing, what should be the resemblance? What should be the angle of variation? And what should be the angle of fusion? There are three angles. Resemblance is known as sarupya and variation is known as vairupya. Fusion is known as sankarya. Wherever two things mix together, it is known as sankarya. Wherever he should resemble, that is known as sarupya. Wherever they should be different, is known as vairupya. If we teach this lesson, modern people, architectural people, even they will start crying. That much of nuances, that much of novelty, that much of deep-rooted wisdom has been hidden inside. Lot of people will be saying that everything is hidden. When you bring few hidden glimpses of knowledge, certainly we are more moved and inspired. So this type of resemblance, the eye should remember, that is, it should resemble the mother. There is a rule. For example, I am saying. But the nose should resemble the father. It should be a fusion of both of them. Or it should have a zero resemblance. What is zero resemblance? Resemblance of some ancestors beyond the thought level or beyond the knowledge level of the parents. Maybe 10 generations before or 20 generations before. So this is known as a zero influence. So it may be a paternal or zenal or maternal or fusion. It may be resemblance, it may be variation. Resemblance means what is the proportion of resemblance. If it is variation, means what is the angle of variation. 10 degrees different from that. 15 degrees deviated from that. So what is the biometrical variation scale or angle of proportionate studies in bioarchitecture? So how deep it is. The third thing is fusion, how to bring all of these things. So there is something going on inside known as bioarchitecture. If your mantras, already there is a model with Tvashta Vishwakarma who is going to design it. If you just move towards that, by means of your practices, if you go along with the inner designing force, if you can prepare some more your designing, personal designing module and which you can entrust to them, there is a possibility of having your dominance of the design rather than the already innate designs. And somebody asked me the question, is it possible to overthrow nature or is it possible to overrule the nature stipulations? It is not so. There is a special munificent provision of the nature itself. We are utilizing only the nature's provision. Mantra, Upasana, Diksha, Guru Padesha, Bhagavad Bhakti, Dhyana, Yajna, all of these things are the special merciful provisions given by the nature itself for adjustability and for overruling. We are not going against it. It is an embedded, it is a well embellished, it is a well organized, inbuilt stabilizer or inbuilt promoter of our life. It is not going against the nucleus of the predestination of the divine order. It is not going like that. So I want to say, you are coming here. There are four things. Those who have done 1/4 of the punya will know these things by hearing and reading. Those who have done 1/2 portions of the, that is half of the punya, they will try to understand it more. They will develop some sort of faith and involvement more. And 3/4 of the punya will make the person to start the practice. And the fullest punya will make the person to complete successfully the practice and to have the benefit in their hands. So you are having 1/4 of the punya.